Welcome to Antenna and Wave Propagation Playlist. In this session, I'll be going to explain antenna apertures. So ultimately, there are various categories of antenna apertures. That is what we need to understand functioning of antenna. So with each antenna apertures, there are different equivalent areas which we need to account to understand how antenna functions. And based on that, it explains power capturing characteristics of antenna. So let us write it so one can understand easily. So with each antenna, we can associate a number of equivalent areas. And these are used to describe power capturing characteristic of antenna. So these are used to describe the power capturing characteristics of antenna. And there are various types of apertures. Apertures means area that is associated with antenna. So different apertures are it could be physical aperture, it could be effective aperture, it could be scattering aperture, it could be loss aperture, or it could be collecting aperture. So in this session, I'll be discussing all those apertures which is explaining power capturing characteristic of antenna. So let us begin this session with first type of aperture, that is physical aperture. Now here one can clearly see I have drawn horn antenna with a physical aperture with an opening of side A and B. So rectangular horn antenna with dimensions A and B is given. Is what dimension A and second dimension is B, that is there with opening. So area of opening, that is physical aperture. The area of opening called as physical aperture. So here physical aperture is AP, that is area with opening, that is A into B. So this is physical aperture of this given antenna. So when we talk about physical aperture, that is different for different antenna. but here I am taking example of horn antenna to explain this. So here rectangular horn antenna with dimension A and B, that is given. So physical aperture of this horn antenna, that is this opening of area, that is A into B. Now what happens is, when electromagnetic waves that is traveling in this direction and that is been received by this horn antenna, in that case, based on its physical aperture, it will be receiving power to the feed. If I say over here there is a feed, then based on this opening, it will be receiving power. So if I say I have electric field which is vertically oriented like this, then this electromagnetic waves that has been received at this end based on its physical aperture. So the incident area of this opening, that is physical aperture. Now if I say power density is W, then based on power density, received power at feed, that should be based on physical aperture. So if incident wave has power density W, then received power that has to be P is equals to power density into physical aperture. Power density is watt per meter square and area that is there in terms of meter square. So received power should be in terms of watts. So this is what ideal calculation which is there with us to have a calculation of received power. So physical aperture, that is based on its dimension, and if power density received here, that is W, so in that case W into physical aperture, that will be received power. But practically that is not happening. So for that we need to calculate effective aperture. So how effective aperture is been calculated, let us try to understand that. So effective aperture, so when we receive power, it is somewhat less than the calculated power because of some reasons. So when we calculate power, that will be P into power density into AP. So when we receive power, it is less than we calculate. So this is what we calculate, and this is what happening because of some reason, due to following reason. So one reason is horn antenna is not having uniform opening. So if this horn antenna that is not having this uniform opening, in that case that could happen. So one reason is horn is not uniform over opening. Second is, when we use this horn antenna, that is made up of metal, it is conducting material. So electric field on the wall must be zero. If it is not zero, in that case there will be a loss. So it is not happening, but practically we need to consider there could be somewhat loss. So electric field at wall must be zero but practically not. And because of that, we receive somewhat less power than the calculated power. Third reason is, if this antenna opening that is not having proper tapering, in that case there could be a loss. So due to tapering loss, that may happen, and because of conduction loss even, signal received is less. So because of conduction loss, that happens. So when we calculate received power, it is not the actual power which is what we are receiving, it is somewhat less than this calculated one. And that is what happening because of these reasons. One is, antenna horn may not be having uniform opening, electric field at wall must be zero, but practically it is not happening. There could be tapering loss or there could be conduction loss. So these are the basic reasons which is resulting into less power received. So if you want to calculate effective aperture, that we can calculate based on aperture efficiency. So to understand, effective aperture, we need to calculate aperture efficiency. And that will leads to calculation of effective aperture. That aperture efficiency, that is effective aperture divided by physical aperture. So physical aperture, that we can calculate based on dimensions. And if we have aperture efficiency, then we can calculate effective aperture. So this is what the basic thing which is there with effective aperture. Now let us try to understand this again. Physical aperture, that is based on dimensions of antenna. There are different sets of antenna, but here I have considered example of horn antenna. So here one can see horn antenna with opening A and B. So physical aperture of this horn antenna, that is A into B. Now here, if I say one electromagnetic wave signal that is arriving to this antenna, then based on power density at this opening, one can calculate what could be the received power. And that received power, that has to be power density into physical aperture. Physical aperture is A into B. So power density into physical aperture, that will be, that has to be received power. But when we calculate received power practically, that is somewhat less than the power which we calculate theoretically. And that is happening because of these reasons. Horn may not be having uniform opening. Electric field at wall must be zero, but practically it is not happening. There could be tapering loss. There could be conduction loss. So that's why received power is less than the power which we calculate. So to understand effective aperture, all we need to calculate is aperture efficiency. So aperture efficiency is effective aperture divided by physical aperture. So that is how we can calculate effective aperture. So physical aperture and effective aperture, that will define aperture efficiency. Now as earlier I have told, there are different sets of aperture. There could be scattering aperture. So scattering aperture, that happens at the border of this horn. Like see, for example, this is what opening, and there are edges even. So these are the edges of that flaring. So what happens is, on this border, electromagnetic waves that is getting scattered. So these are scattering aperture. So from border, there is a possibility of scattering. Now there could be a loss aperture, and that loss that is happening because of so many reasons. That loss may be happening because of tapering loss. It may be happening because of conduction loss. So that is associated with loss aperture. And this opening, that is what collecting aperture. So this opening is receiving those electromagnetic waves which is arriving to this horn antenna. So this aperture, which is having relevance with this opening, that is what collecting aperture. So that is how there are different sets of aperture that will justify how much capturing characteristic is there with this given antenna, and based on that one can calculate how much power that should get received at antenna. So again, in brief, let us try to understand physical aperture, that is based on dimensions of antenna. So here with this horn antenna, dimensions are A and B, and based on that one can calculate received power. That has to be power density into physical aperture, but practically received power is less than the power which we theoretically calculate, and that is happening because of these reasons. Horn antenna is not uniform over opening. Electric field at wall must be zero, but practically it is not happening. There could be tapering loss, there could be conduction loss. So that is the reasons because of what we don't receive the power which is what we calculate theoretically. So to understand effective aperture, we need to calculate aperture efficiency. So aperture efficiency, that is effective aperture by physical aperture. And here I have told there are different sets of other apertures like scattering aperture, loss aperture, collecting aperture. So scattering, that is happening because of edges most of the times. Like if edges are not proper, if edges are not sharp, in that case there will be scattering from the edges of any antenna. And loss could happen because of material, conducting material or dielectric material in any antenna. So here we have conducting material as a horn. So there could be a loss because of electric field is not zero at the wall. And collecting aperture, that is what showing you how much electromagnetic waves that it can collect. So here this is what the opening where it will be collecting electromagnetic waves. So this is what collecting aperture. So that is how there are different sets of aperture which is associated with antenna, and that explains you capturing characteristic of antenna. Thank you so much for watching this video. You can see my website in link, so you can go through my website where I have given detail regarding what courses that I'm offering, and one can go through my website where in future I'll be uploading all those documents which is required to understand those subjects which I'm teaching over here on YouTube. So in future even I'll be adding my Android application. So you just go through the link which is there in description to see my website, and in my description even I'm adding my applications link, so one can download it from there. Thank you so much for watching this video.